Good morning friends, welcome to Dinesh Meghlani Tutorials. In this session we are going to study about narration, our session number 3. And basic thing that we are going to study in this session is how to convert your direct speech into indirect speech for interrogative sentences. Right, here we are going to understand 4 interrogative sentences. Either they are starting with helping verb or auxiliaries or WH series or with yes or no. Primarily we have 4 different varieties of question in this for interrogative series. For more videos you may log in to my website www.dineshmeghlani.com or my Facebook page Dinesh Meghlani Tutorials. For any query you may WhatsApp at my number 0921551435 or my email ID legalbuddy@gmail.com. For regular updates on my videos you may subscribe my YouTube channel Dinesh Meghlani Tutorials. I expect from you to share my videos on your Facebook wall as well as with your friends so that they will also be benefited by this. Let us start with this session for interrogative sentences. How to convert interrogative sentences, right? We know that interrogative sentences will starts with either helping verb or auxiliaries. So what are the rules for that? The reporting verb is changed into ask, inquire, inquire or demand. Generally change into ask, right? But as generally that is changed into ask, because when we talk about when they are not interrogative, when they are assertive sentences, so there we change into tell, right? Here we change into ask. Rest as per to the question requirement, we may change into inquire or demand as per to the statement. No conjunction is used to introduce the reported speech if the question begins with WH series. Right, means no, that, no, if have to be used for inverted commas. If it starts with WH series means what, who, whose, which, when, where, why, how, who. Means if it starts with WH series, there is no need to use any conjunction there. So no conjunction is required to be used for inverted commas. If or whether is used to introduce a reported speech if the question is in yes or no and begins with a helping verb, do, does, is, am, are, was, were, right? Means if the question begins with is, am, are, was, were, by any helping verb or any auxiliary, in that case we use either if. In that case what we use, either we use if or whether. I hope that is clear. Means first thing is that when we have a WH series, no conjunction is used. And the second thing is when we have auxiliaries or the modals, in that case we use if or whether. If the sense of must, necessity or compulsion is shown at the time of speaking, it will change into had to. That reporting verb have to be changed into had to. And if the same necessity or compulsion shows in future, it will change into would have to. So that with the example we may try to understand sometime. If I say I have to go there, it's a compulsion. They have to be changed into had to or would have to. Change the question in the statement, put full stop in the mark in place of interrogation. There is no mark of interrogation have to be used. Now in the last it should be full stop. Observe the same rule while you change tense of the verb, pronoun, word showing nearness. All the rules that we have studied earlier for tenses, changing of pronouns and words showing nearness, the same rule have to be followed. Interrogative sentences beginning with shall are changed into indirect speech as it. Let us have now example. Let us have few examples here. Ram said, shall I ever cheat you? Right. It means that by the statement it's clear that shall I ever cheat you? Matlab Ram ne bada achambe se bola, right? So what I can say that Ram wondered if, now we have to change because that interrogative have to be converted into assertive. So I as in subjective case, I as a first person change as to subject, he, would ever cheat, now you as a second person, right? So that have to be changed as to the object. It means that by the question it's clear that Ram is talking to me, it means object is me, so you have to be me. So right, I can say that Ram wondered if he would ever cheat me. She said, shall I lend you my necklace? She asked if I have to be changed, she should lend me her necklace. Right, because शी इज टॉकिंग टू मी, इट मीन्स दैट माई ऑब्जेक्ट वुड बी आई एंड मी, तो देयर आई कैन कंपेयर यू हेयर इन टू द मी. ही सेड टू हर, शैल आई अकंपनी यू टू आगरा, राइट? ही आस्ट हर, आस्ट, जनरली वी यूज आस्ट हर बिकॉज इट्स स्टार्टिंग विद ऑक्सिलरी और विल शैल इज एम आर, वी यूज इफ, देन आई सब फर्स्ट पर्सन एज टू द सब्जेक्ट, ही वुड अकंपनी, देन यू, यू इज सेकेंड पर्सन चेंज एज पर टू द ऑब्जेक्ट, हर टू आगरा बिकॉज यू हैव टू प्लेस हर टू आगरा, राइट? He asked her if he would accompany her to Agra. He said to us, has she been spinning since yesterday? He asked us if, right now, she, third person no change, has been spinning. So that is past, is present perfect continuous. So we have to convert into the past perfect continuous. She had been spinning since yesterday into the previous day, right? So we can say that he asked us if she had been spinning since the previous day. He said to them, were you not scolding your sons? He asked them if. Now when we talk about you, you is the second person change as per the object, so we have to write here they. If they, now were not scolding, it means that is past continuous have to be changed into past perfect continuous, had not been scolding their son, right? So what we can say, he asked them if they had not been scolding their sons, because you are second person change as per to the object, that becomes their sons. Sentences with yes or no. Right, in these cases, first of all, we combine them. Let's have, are there any more files? He said, yes, sir, said the PN. Means that he asked from the PN, are there any more files? The PN said, yes, sir, right? He asked to the PN, means he asked the PN, first step, if, right? Then, are there any more files? There were any more files, right? And PN said, yes, sir. Okay. I said to him, and we may add and replied, yes, sir. I said to him, do you want to go to Chandigarh? He said, no, sir. I asked him if he wanted to go to Chandigarh, same. Then we have to add, and respectively, he replied in negative because he said, no, sir. Right? We can say he replied negatively. He replied in negative, right? She said to me, shall we ever see each other again? I said, perhaps never. She asked me if we would ever see each other again, but I replied that it would perhaps never be. Now, these are some general sentences we use, right, for converting into the indirect speech. When we have interrogative words like WH series, he said to me, whom does she want to contact? He asked me, there is no need to use if for that, whom. Now she, no change, present indefinite into past indefinite, wanted to contact, that's your answer. We said to them, who has misguided you? We asked them, who, then has misguided, present perfect into past perfect, had misguided you. You means second person change as per to the object, so we have to write here them. We said to them, when shall we have paid you a visit, right? So what we can say that we asked them when, right? We, first person change as per to the subject, we would have paid them a visit, because you, second person change as per to the object, here we have them. So when we would have paid visit, we would have paid them a visit. Question beginning with modal auxiliaries. In the modal auxiliaries, the things remain the same. We know that may will convert it into might, can in could, right, will in would. Otherwise, the old rules will remain the same. I said to him, may Sunita come in to discuss with you something? I asked him if Sunita will remain same, may will convert into might, कम इन टू डिस्कस विद यू, यू एज ए ऑब्जेक्ट राइट, हिम समथिंग. आई सेड टू हर कुड यू गिव मी योर नोट्स, आई आस्क्ड हर राइट. नाउ यू एज ए सेकेंड पर्सन हैव टू बी ऑब्जेक्ट, शी कुड बिकॉज यू हैव कुड हेयर, शी कुड गिव मी योर नोट्स बिकॉज हेयर वी हैव मी, तो मी एज पर टू दैट शी कुड गिव मी हर नोट्स राइट. ही आस्क्ड, ही सेड टू द टीचर मे आई गो टू लाइब्रेरी, ही आस्क्ड द टीचर इफ राइट, देन वी हैव टू से आई हैव टू द सब्जेक्ट, ही मे हैव टू बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू माइट, ही माइट गो टू द लाइब्रेरी. मीन्स ऑल रूल विल रिमेन द सेम, ओनली इन द ऑक्सिलरी यू हैव टू टेक केयर ऑफ दैट. In place of the inverted comma, we have to use if, right? And after that, whatever rule we are following earlier, those rules have to be followed. So this is end to our third session of narration. In this session, we try to understand how to convert interrogative sentences into the indirect speech. I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you very much. You may send your feedback to me at my email ID. legalbuddy@gmail.com or connect me on my Facebook @DineshMiglani, my WhatsApp number 0921551435. I expect from you to share my videos on your Facebook wall as well as with your friends so that they will also be benefited by this. Thank you very much.